Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 Antak
Antak
Purusha
Purusha
Rupena
Rupena
Satvana,
Satvana,
Bhagavan,
Bhagavan,
Atma,
Atma,
Mayaya,
Mayaya,
Antak Purusha Rupena,
Antak Purusha Rupena,
Kala Rupena Yobahi,
Kala Rupena Yobahi,
Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Samanvetyesha Satvana, Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Bhagavan Atma Mayaya,
Bhagavan Atma Mayaya,
Antak Purusha Rupena,
Antak Purusha Rupena,
Kala Rupena Yobahi,
Kala Rupena Yobahi,
Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Samanvetyesha Satvana,
Bhagavan Atma Mayaya,
Bhagavan Atma Mayaya.
By exhibiting his potencies, the Supreme Personality of Godhead adjusts all these different elements, keeping himself within as the Supersoul and without as time.
Antap purusha rupena kala rupena jo bahi samanne tesha satyana bhagavan atmamaya. Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is exhibiting himself in so many ways, that is summarized in the Vishnu Purana, just like the heat and light. Just like in the material world, we have got experience. The whole system of the material world is going on under the heat and light. The sun sign is diffusing unlimited quantity of heat and light, and on this heat and light the whole material existence is there. That is scientific estimate. Because the sunlight is there, the heat and light is there, the whole planetary system is rotating, there is vegetation and varieties of foods, flowers, varieties of manifestation. This is heat and light. Similarly, the example is given in the Vishnu Purana. Eko desha sthita shagne jyotsna vistarina jatha parasya brahmana shakti sarvedam akhilam jagat. Just like agni, fire, eko desha sthita is there in one place, localized. Agni does not move, but heat moves. That you have got experience. You have a big fire in one place. The fire does not move, but you can feel the existence of fire by heat and light. Similarly, Bhagavan does not move. He has got immense power. Parasam Shakti Vividhaiva Sriyate. He moves by his energy. That is the difference between the Mahabharata philosopher and Vaishnava philosopher. Vaishnava philosopher says the Bhagavan is staying in one place. Goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuto. He is staying. In the Shastra we understand that Krishna Vrindavanam parityajya na padamekam gacchati. Krishna does not leave even by step Vrindavan. He always remains there. So, in the Brahma Sanghita also it is stated that Goloka eva nivasati akhilatma bhuta. He is always living in Goloka Vrindavan. He does not require to move. That is his inconceivable potency. Suppose I am sitting here, suppose I have got to do something in my apartment, so unless I go there, that business cannot be performed. This is my position. But Krishna, although he does not leave even by step Goloka Vrindavan, he is always enjoying in company Srimati Radharani, Anandamaya Vyasa. His only business is Ananda, Satchidananda Vigraha. But he has got so many other businesses. So many. He has to sarvasya chaham ridhisanni vishta, Krishna says, that I am situated in everyone's heart. And matta smriti jnanam apohananja. And through me, the living entity is getting intelligence, remembrance. So just see how much busy he is. Everyone's heart, Ishara Paramak, Ishara Sarvabhutanam Riddeshe Arjuna Tishtha. Ishara, the super soul, it is said here, antar purusha rupena, the super soul. And the Bhagavad Gita also confirmed, sarvasya chaham hridishanni vishta. He is situated in everyone's heart. In the Upanishad also it is said that two birds are sitting in one tree. So one bird is eating the fruit and the other bird is simply observing as witness. Anumanta upadrashta in the Bhagavad Gita. So just imagine there is no limit of the living entities. So anantaya kalpata. Anantaya means there is no numerical count. Innumerable. Nitya Nityanam. Nityanam, Bahubachan, plural number. So there is no limit of these living entities. And still, Krishna has to live within the heart of every living entity. Just see, and every living entity has different business. And he has to sanction and witness. There is a common saying that not a blade of grass can move without the sanction of God. Actually, that is the fact. Everyone has got different propensities. And he cannot do it without the sanction of God. This is God's business. Just see. Ananta Koti, innumerable jiva, and he has to give sanction and see his business and witness, also give the result, his witness, and he has to give the result also, because he is doing independently. He must enjoy or suffer the activities that is going on. Karmana daiva netrena. He has to give different types of body. Suppose I want to eat everything, never mind how much nonsense and nuisance it is. There are so many men, they eat everything. So he has to be offered the body of a pig. No discrimination, even stool accepted. So who is giving this body? Daivanetrena, by superior observation. Krishna is saying that this living entity wants a body so that he can eat anything up to stool. So he has to judge, he has to give karmana daivanetrena jantar deho upatti. So we are getting different types of body according to the... Krishna does not give directly because he is the Supreme Lord. He has nothing to do. Natasya karjam karanancha vidyate. This is the Vedic information. He has nothing to do. Simply his order is sufficient. That is also confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishthati brahmayan sarvabhutani jantra rurhani maya. So Krishna orders only maya that give this living entity a body like a demigod or a dog or a pig or a tree. So there are 8,400,000 varieties of body. He has to manage all this. How is managing? Is he managing personally? No. He's managing through his potency. Atmamaya. Here it is said, Atmamaya. Samanteti esa satyana Bhagavan. Atmamaya. Maya means energy. Energy, tricks. This is called Maya. So everything is being done by his potency. So the Mayavadi philosopher, they say, when Bhagavan is everywhere, his action is visible in every step, every atom, everywhere, then the original, where is the original form of Bhagavan? Everything is Bhagavan. That is called Nirvisheshvadi, Nirakarvadi. Bhagavan has no akar. He is finished. Because he is everywhere, therefore, there cannot be any particular form of God. This is Nirvisheshvadi. That is material conception. Just like if we take something and make into pieces, and throw it everywhere, the original form of that particular thing is finished. This is material conception. But spiritual conception is different. Spiritual conception is stated in the Vedas, purnasya purnamadaya purnameva avasishyati. Krishna is Purna and he has expanded himself in so many ways, so many potencies, so many forms, but still he is Krishna. That is Krishna. You cannot think that because Krishna is expanded in so many forms and so many ways, therefore he is finished. There is no more Krishna. This form of Krishna is Maya. No. That is Krishna. The Krishna can expand himself. Advaite achyuti anadi anantarupam. Anantarupam. You cannot count him. We are also forms of Krishna. Vibhinnaṃsa. Everything is Krishna's form. The pantheism, they take it that Krishna, everything is Krishna's form, then where is Krishna? No. Krishna is still Krishna. Advaita achyuti anadi anantarupam adyang purana purusam navajau vananj. This is still adyam. Purusham adyam govindam adi purusam tamahang bhajami. He still remains adi. So how he has expanded, that is stated here. Bhagavan Atma Mayaya, by his internal potency. Bhagavan Atma Mayaya, Prasa Shakti Vividhai Vastyate, the example is given. Just that the sun is localized in one place, but he is managing the whole universal affair by his heat and light. That is potency. That does not mean for time immemorial, sun is supplying unlimited quantity of heat and light all over the universe, day and night. There is no stoppage. It is not that sun's heat and light has been stopped because it is night. It is night for us. But his heat and light is being distributed. But still, this as the sun has diminished by a small quantity, if it is possible, even for the material thing, sun is nothing but an insignificant material thing. There are millions of suns, millions and trillions of suns. That is admitted even by modern science. So, this sun is only an insignificant portion of the sun category. This universe is the smallest. There are many big universes. And each in every universe there is sun, there is moon, there is other things. And all these universes combined together is 1/4 energy of Krishna. Ekaṃsinastitu jagat. When Arjuna wanted to know about Krishna's potencies, vibhuti, he said in so many ways, then at last he summarized, athabha bahunaitena kingyatena tava arjuna vishtabha aham idam krishnam ekaṃsina sthitu. You just try to understand my potency in this way, that the whole material creation, cosmic manifestation, innumerable universes. What are these universes? Jasyaika nishyasita kala mathavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha. In each and every universe there is a prime lord or the creator, the Lord Brahma. So there are innumerable universes and there are innumerable Lord Brahmas, innumerable Lord Shivas, everything innumerable. So, jasyaika nishyasita kala mathavalamba, and these innumerable universes are coming out from the breathing of Mahavishnu. That Mahavishnu is partial expansion of Krishna. Jasyaika nishyasita kala mathavalamba jivanti loma vilaja jagadanna natha Vishnu mahanasahu yajasya kalavishesa. Kalavishesa means kala, an angsa. Angsa is directly and kala is Aṅśa of the Aṅśa. There is so many things to understand the science of Krishna. Therefore Krishna says that jatatāma vi siddhyānām koshchit vetimām tattva. There are many siddhas. We are not siddhas. We are trying to be siddhas. Manushānām sahasreṣu koshchit jatati siddhay. Not all. Just like here, the bhakti yoga is going on, how to become siddha. But who is interested? And in Bombay there are millions of people, but who is interested? Therefore, Krishna says, manushānām sahasreṣu koshchit jatati siddhay. There are millions and millions of human beings, but out of them, one may be interested to become siddha. And if one is siddha, jatatamapi siddhanam, and all those siddhas, those are actually siddhas, they are trying to understand Krishna. Koshchit, out of some, out of them, somebody may be knowing Krishna. Therefore, the Krishna science is not so easy. So therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has advised, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta. Any person who knows the science of Krishna, he is Guru, not others. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru. Kiba Sudra Kiba Vipra Nasikane Noa. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Raya was talking about spiritual realization. So Ramananda Raya was from a Sudra family and he was householder and governor of Madras, politician also. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was asking question from him, and this is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lila. Mukam karati bachala. How he is making a Sudra, Grihastha, politician, his guru, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So nobody can become Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's guru, but he was playing the part. He was questioning, and Ramananda Raya was replying. So just imagine how his position was exalted. So he was little hesitating when very intricate questions were put before him. He was quite able to answer, he was answering. So he was feeling little hesitation, said he was coming out of a very high Brahmin family and the most learned personality, and now you have taken sannyas, the supermost position in the human society. Sannyas is very respectable position. Still, it is honored in India. Anyone where sannyasi goes, at least in the villages, they offer respectful obeisances and gives all kinds of comfort. Still now, according to Shastra, it is said, if a sannyasi is not offered respect or duly honored, the punishment is the man should fast at least one day. This is Vedic system. But there are many sannyasis taking advantage of this. So we are not concerned. Neither Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a false sannyasi, he was real sannyasi, and he was also real grihastha, Ramananda Raya. So he was feeling little hesitation. To encourage him, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately said, no, why you are feeling hesitation? why you are feeling inferior? You are Guru. Now how I am Guru? That Jai Krishna Tattavetta Sai Guru Ha. Because to become a knower of Krishna is not ordinary position. Jatatama Vishidhyala. Kaschid Bhitti Mahantatta. One who has known Krishna is not ordinary man. Jatatama Vishidhyana. He is above all the Siddhas. So why you are hesitating? You know Krishna Tattva, therefore I am asking from you. So this is the position. So this Krishna consciousness movement means that training the people who come to us to make him far, far above than the Siddhas. Far, far above than the Siddhas. And it is very easily. One can become, one can hold this position of Guru, which Guru means who is above the Siddhas. Krishna Tattvavetta. Jai Krishna Tattvavetta Sei Guru. One cannot become Guru unless he knows Krishna Tattva. Not ordinary man. The yogis, the karmis, the jnanis, they cannot become Guru. That is not sanctioned. Because even one is jnani, he has to learn Krishna after many, many births. Not in one life, but many, many lives. If he persists to understand what is the absolute truth by his jnana method, by his speculative method, then still he'll have to change many, many births. Then one day he may be fortunate. If he comes in contact with the devotee, then it may be possible for him to understand Krishna. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan maang prapadyate. Who prapadyate? Who surrenders to Krishna? Unless one understands Krishna perfectly, why one should surrender? Krishna says, sarva dhanman parityajya mamekam saranam braja. Big scholars, it is too much. They say, it is too much. Krishna is demanding, mamekam saranam braja. This is too much. This is not too much, this is the real position. If he is actually advanced in knowledge, bhunam janmanamante, that is not attainable in one life. If he persists in knowledge, understanding of the absolute truth, then after many, many births, when he is actually in knowledge, then he surrenders to Krishna. Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurlava. That kind of mahatma, you'll find so many mahatmas simply by changing the dress. Not that kind of mahatma. Sa mahatma sudurlava. It is very difficult to find out such mahatmas. But there are. If one is fortunate, he can meet such mahatma and his life becomes successful. Sa mahatma sudurlava. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has made the thing very easy. Very, very easy. Therefore, his name is Patit Pavan. Patit Pavan. Patit means fallen. And Pavan means purifier. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, therefore, we follow Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We first of all sing, chant, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar, Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakti. We beg mercy from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates. That is the way of worship in this age. He cannot approach Krishna, then it will be sudurlava. Manushanam sahasyesu kaschid jatati siddhaya jatatama vishiddhana. If you try to approach Krishna, actually we are seeing that. The Bhagavad Gita is being read by so many scholars, so many theosophists and theists, but they do not understand Krishna. You'll find it practically. So many big scholars, so many men, they say, I read Bhagavad Gita thrice in a day. And ask him about Krishna, he doesn't know anything. He'll find it practical. He'll be very proud of reading Bhagavad Gita. And the politician, they take photograph, taking a Bhagavad Gita in his hand, and asking about Krishna, he doesn't know anything. Satkanda Ramayana pare Sitakar Baba. He has read all the Ramayana and he is asking, well, can you say me whose father is Sita? He does not know whether Sita is mother or father. So this is the position. Because he does not know who is Guru and how to learn Bhagavad Gita, therefore he is frustrated. Krishna says, tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sivaya upadakshanti tad jnanam jnanina tattva darshan. Even Krishna is friend of Arjuna. Still Arjuna says, shishasti ham sadhimam prapannam. Krishna says, Arjuna says, Krishna, no more friendly talking. I agree to become your disciple. Now when he agreed to become disciple of Krishna, then he explained Bhagavad Gita. Actually, one should not explain Bhagavad Gita or any Vedic Shastra unless one has agreed to become a disciple. But devotees are so kind that they preach even among the non-disciples just to take them to Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, according to law, one should not speak beyond the jurisdiction of his disciple because they will not understand. They will not follow the rules and regulations. How they will understand? Hey, Krishna says, jisham tu antagatam papam. One who is completely freed from all kinds of sinful activities. That is the primary qualification to understand Krishna or understand Bhagavad Gita. Jisham tu antagatam papam. Jananam punyakarmanam. Te dandamahanin mukta bhajanti vangadirabhrita. Unless one comes to this position, there is no possibility of Krishna consciousness. So how outsiders will accept? If the outsider is requested, sir, you do not smoke, very small thing, then Swamiji is not very good. He puts so many restrictions. And if Swamiji, you can drink, you can eat anything, it is nothing. And then he is very liberal. So, we are, first of all, putting this restriction. No illicit sex. No meat eating. No intoxication. No gambling. Intoxication after drinking tea and smoking cigarette. You have to give up. Anyone who comes to my become my disciple. This is my first proposal. If you agree, then you come. It is not that you can do anything nonsense you like and you become my disciple. No. Because one cannot understand Krishna unless he is restricted from the sinful activities. And these are the basic principles of sinful activities. Illicit sex and meat eating, gambling and intoxication. These are the four pillars of sinful life. And the whole world is addicted to these four things. So, we have to push on Krishna consciousness with great difficulty. When I went to America, I went by sea, so this it stopped at the, what is that, Commonwealth Pier in Boston. So I was thinking that if I say that no illicit sex, no meat eating, and no intoxication, and no gambling, so these people will immediately say, please go home. Yes, that is the position. These are their daily affairs. These are their daily affairs in Western countries. And if you want to make them stop these things, they will think that this man is lunatic. But by Krishna's grace, these boys, these girls, they agreed. That is Krishna's grace. I did not expect that they will agree. In India, they do not agree, and they are accustomed from childhood, from boyhood. So how they will? But Krishna's grace is so nice. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is so great that they agreed, and they are pushing on this movement, on this principle. So why? This is due to the grace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Patit Pavan. He can deliver the Jagai Madhai. And what is the process? The process is Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Iva Kevalam Kalau Nasti Iva, Nasti Iva, Nasti Iva, Gatinannatha. If people are simply induced to chant Hare Krishna Mantra, just see, even as child he is taking part. It is natural. There is no distinction between black and white, no question of language, nothing. You see practically. There is white child, black child, they do not know how to speak, but they are dancing and chanting. So this movement is so important. Somehow or other, if you can engage them in chanting and dancing, the whole world will be united. What the United Nations has failed, this movement can do, if it is not checked by the rascals. But the rascals are ready to check this movement. That is the difficulty. Otherwise, God, Krishna, is always ready to help us. How? Yet he said, Anta Purusa Rupena Kala Rupena Jabohi. He is inside and outside. Antar, Antajyami. Chaitya Guru. He is acting as Chaitya Guru. Krishna is very much anxious. Because we are suffering and we are sons of Krishna. We are part and parcel of Krishna. Is unhappy to see that you are suffering. That is natural. Like the son is suffering from ailments, the father also suffers. How the son will be cured? The son may not know it, but the father is suffering without having that ailments. Similarly, Krishna, he is the father of all living entities. Ahanga bija padapita. Krishna says, it is not my word, but Krishna says, sarva jivanishu kaunteya, all different forms of life, sambhavanti, ahanga bija padapita. So Krishna is the father of everyone. And he is very much anxious for us to get us back. Therefore he is ordinary. You rascal, why you have created so many isms? Just surrender to me. I give you protection. Just surrender. Sarvadhanman parityaja mamekam saranam vraj. For this purpose he comes. Jada jada hi dhanmasya glani bhavati bharat. Dhanmaglani, discrepancies in the matter of religious principle, glani. What is that glani? The glani is forgetfulness of God. No God, I am God, you are God. This is glani. But this is going on as dharma. This is Kali Yuga. What is not dharma, that is going on as dharma. Dharma means to understand God. Dharmantu sakshat bhagavat pranita. What is dharma? Dharma means the laws and instruction given by God. But at the present moment, what is God? There is no God. Then where is dharma? What is dharma? So there is no dharma in the Kali Yuga. They are simply cheating. Therefore Bhagavad says, dharma projita koitava atra. Atra srimadha bhagavate. In the srimadha bhagavatam, all cheating type of religious system is kicked out. What is that cheating type? There is no God. Then where is dharma? Dharma means you become honest. But they do not know that nobody can become honest without Krishna consciousness. That is not possible. Harava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. Anyone who is devoid of God consciousness, he cannot be gentleman. Harava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. Jashyasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana. Sarvai gunai tatra samasate sura. Harava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. This is the test. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Namanga duskitanam mura prabadante naradhama. Maya purita jnana asuri bhavamasrita. So this is the test. Namang prapadante. Krishna says, who does not surrender to me? And they are these classes of men. What is that? Duskritina. Always engaged in sinful activities. Kriti means meritorious. But they are engaged in manufacturing atom bombs. Duskritina. Atom bomb means killing. But they discover something by which man will not die. That they are dying, so you have discovered some instrument to die quickly. That is duskritina. Merit, he has got merit, but misuse the merit. The death is there, he would have lived for, say, 60 years, and you drop atom bomb in 10 years or 20 years, finished. We cannot increase the duration of life. Therefore, the so-called scientific advancement, what is that? Duskritina. No benefit for the human society. The real problem is, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha dosanu darshan. Our real miserable condition of life is birth, death, old age and disease. So where is scientific help to mitigate these miseries? There is no stoppage of birth, there is no stoppage of death, there is no stoppage of disease. You can manufacture very good medicine for disease, but you stop disease. That is not. So our so-called meritorious activities in scientific research and education, they have been described in the Bhagavad Gita as duskriti, mischievous activities, duskriti. They are not actually beneficial, but they are mischievous. And why mischievous they are engaged? They are wasting their so much time in mischief. Because mura, they do not know what is the purpose of life. They are muras. Namang duskitanam mura prapadante naradhama. They do not surrender to Krishna because they are naradhama, lowest of the mankind. Why lowest of the mankind? Because this human life was given to him for understanding Krishna and he is wasting in other way. They are naradhama. But they are so educated, university degree, maya purita jnana. Then knowledge has no meaning. it is taken away by Maya, because he does not understand Krishna. What is the use of such knowledge? Veda ishta sarvai ahameva veda. Veda means knowledge. See, if you actually advance his knowledge, you must know what is Krishna. But they do not know Krishna. Rather, they are defying Krishna. So this is going on. Therefore, this Krishna consciousness movement is very, very important. Those who are intelligent, they will take to it and make his life successful. Thank you very much.